While you may or may not be familiar with the word sycophant, you likely are familiar with one of the many slang phrases that mean the same thing as sycophant. Terms like brown noser, suck up, kiss up, butt kisser, yes man, bootlicker, toady, these are all colloquial terms that mean the same thing as sycophant. Another colloquial term that is closely related to sycophant is social climber. I wouldn't say that a social climber is exactly the same thing as a sycophant, but I would say that most social climbers are sycophants, and most of them will use sycophant tactics in addition to other tactics. For that reason, if you are good at identifying who is a brown noser, then you are also probably good at identifying who is a social climber. One thing about sycophants is they can often be difficult to recognize because many sycophants behave in a very similar way to people who are genuine supporters. I will get into the reasons why they are difficult to recognize in a bit. Dictionary.com defines sycophant as a self-seeking, servile flatterer, a fawning parasite. It's important to differentiate between a sycophant and a true supporter. Unlike a true supporter, a sycophant does what they do for self-seeking reasons. They do not do what they do because they are genuinely supportive, and they would not do what they do if they didn't think that there was anything in it for them. I also like this definition because it points out that sycophants are parasites. A lot of people don't realize this, but sycophants actually are parasitic to their targets, or to their hosts, if you will. Sycophants are often harmful to the people they target. For example, if a boss at work is always promoting and otherwise playing favorites and rewarding people who are sycophants, as opposed to rewarding people who are true, genuine supporters who might be more competent and might be harder working than the sycophants, that will A, hurt the corporation because it means the wrong people are being favored, the wrong people are being promoted, and the wrong people have power and influence. And B, it will also undermine the morale of the employees at the corporation. A sycophant will target someone who has more power than them, or someone who, at the very least, they perceive has more power than them. Now, there are many ways in which power can manifest, and there's probably a limitless number of ways in which you can have sycophants. But some of the more talked about situations that often have sycophants are corporate situations in which yes men and kiss ups will brown nose the people who are their bosses or the people who are higher up on the corporate ladder than they are. Celebrities are also known to often have sycophants around them, and sycophants often appear in social circles in which sycophants kiss up to people who have more social status than they do. Now, like I said, these are just some of the more talked about ones. There are probably an endless number of power situations in which you might have sycophants. Unfortunately, it's often rather difficult to tell who is a sycophant. And that's because sycophants often behave in a way that is similar to the way an actual supportive person would behave. Another reason it can be difficult to tell who is a sycophant is because it's human nature to like the people who are supportive of you. After all, if someone is supportive of you, usually you will want to believe that this person is in fact a true supporter rather than just a self-serving parasite. Another reason it can be very difficult to tell who a sycophant is as opposed to who a genuine supporter is because some sycophants are actually quite skilled in fooling you into believing that they are true, genuine supporters. For that reason, in this video, I'm going to give you my top 5 list on how to identify a sycophant. I want to warn you that this is not an exhaustive list. Not all sycophants do the things that are on this list, and there are other ways of identifying a sycophant besides the things on this list. This list is just meant to be a general guideline. Number 5. Sycophants often imitate the target's tastes, opinions, fashion, style, and mannerisms. Now, the reason why I made this number 5 on my list rather than higher up is because this is something that you often will see actual genuine supporters do as well. But it is true that sycophants often do this, and sycophants often go to great lengths to imitate people's style and mannerisms, and will often enthusiastically share their target's opinions and tastes in things. Whether or not someone is behaving this way because they are a true sycophant or because they are an actual genuine supporter is something of a judgment call. Number 4. Some sycophants may only have friends with more power or status than they have. Now, again, this is something that is not true of all sycophants, and it's also something that it could be true of someone who is a genuine supporter as well. However, this kind of behavior is more common amongst sycophants than actual supporters. If someone only seems to have friends with other people who have more status or power that they can leech off of, that is a possible sign that this person is indeed a sycophant. Number 3. Sycophants often take their target's side in any interpersonal dispute unless the target gets involved in a dispute with another high-status individual. Of course, it's often human nature to take the side of people who are our friends or people whom we trust when that person gets involved in an interpersonal dispute. However, what a lot of sycophants do is they will very enthusiastically take the side of their target in any interpersonal dispute that the target may have with someone else, whether or not the target is in the right. However, if the target gets involved in a interpersonal dispute with someone else who is also high status, then the sycophant may be very reluctant to want to take sides. This can often be the case, even if the sycophant actually believes that the target is in the right. And this is especially true if the other high status individual is someone who the sycophant views as a target as well, or as a potential target. Number 2. Sycophants often highly praise and defend their targets, but not when the target is not around or they think the target won't find out about it. Now, this one is actually a pretty strong indication that a person is really a sycophant, and that's because people who are true supporters generally do not act like this. Sycophants will commonly talk highly of and praise and defend their target when their target is around, or when their target is not around, but they feel that there is a relatively good chance that their target will find out about it. Now, I want to warn you that most sycophants actually are pretty good at talking about their target in a very laudatory way and defending their target when they feel that there is a good enough chance that their target will find out about it, even if their target is not around. And in some cases, they will do so even if they only feel there is a very remote possibility that their target will find out. But if you find that someone is not really willing to talk highly of and praise and defend their target the way they normally do when they don't feel that there is a very strong possibility that their target will find out about it, or when their target is not present, that is a pretty strong sign that this person is not a genuine supporter, but just a self-serving parasite. Number 1. Toxic sycophants will kiss up and punch down, or punch laterally. The reason why this is number 1 on this list is, not only is this kind of behavior a very strong indicator that someone is a sycophant, it also means that they are not an ordinary sycophant, but a toxic sycophant. Toxic sycophants brown nose the people that they target, who they believe have higher status or power than they do, but will abuse the people whom they believe have less power and status than they do. In some cases, toxic sycophants will also abuse those whom they have. You want to be especially vigilant at identifying people who are toxic sycophants, because toxic sycophants, generally speaking, have greater potential to do damage and harm to their target and to the people around their target than ordinary sycophants do. So if you like this video, go ahead and give it a like, and if you haven't already, subscribe to my channel, click the bell icon for notifications, join the Zork Army, and together we shall take over the world. I upload 5 videos a month. You can also follow me on Twitter, Instagram, and Snapchat at ZorkMid123.